Welcome to Plates of Flavor. Today, I'm going to show you how to make idli batter. For that, the ingredients required are idli rice or parboiled rice, raw rice, udad dal or split gram dal, and some methi or also called as fenugreek. Now, this is the approximate measurement that I have taken for today. This is 2 cups of parboiled rice or idli rice. I have taken this cup for measurement, and this is 2 cups of parboiled or idli rice. So add it to your bowl. This is 1 cup of raw rice to this cup measurement. Add that too to this bowl. Add a little bit of fenugreek, that is, there is no exact measurement, but a little bit added to it. Now, to make a good idli set, to make good fluffy idlis, we need to soak rice separately and dal separately, udad dal separately. So this is 3/4 udad dal. For this measurement, we need 3/4 of udad dal. This is 3/4 of udad dal measured along with this cup. Let's soak it separately. Add in sufficient amount of water and let this soak for at least 5 to 6 hours. Now I have soaked the same thing in double measurement separately and I have soaked it for 6 hours. Let me show you. Let's now wash the udad dal and the rice which has been soaked. The udad dal is cleaned up and now the rice. I'm draining out all the excess water that is there in here. The rice is washed and the udad dal is now washed. Now let's get ready for grinding. This could be done in a wet grinder or in the ordinary.
I'm going to now grind this in my mixie grinder. I generally grind at home.
So first let's grind the udad dal. I'm going to take in the whole quantity of udad dal. You can take in whatever quantity mixes well or fits in well into your mixer grinder. You could use a wet grinder or your mixie would also just do fine to make up good fluffy idlis. This should be ground to a very smooth paste. So just breaking it down would not be sufficient. I have been now grinding for about 2 minutes. And please note that you could add minimal amount of water to the udad dal. The udad dal should be nice and fluffy and should be ground with minimal amount of water, because idli batter requires very less water. Now, I have been grinding for about 2 to 3 minutes. The udad dal should raise very well. Let me show this to you. See, it's nice and lot fluffy. And now, I'm going to remove it out into my container, in which I'm going to ferment my idli batter for the day. Now, let's grind the rice. It can be done in the same jar. I have just emptied out the entire udad dal mixture. And now, I'm going to put in this
rice mixture, probably in two portions because the amount I have soaked is quite large, so it might take time to grind. The rice should be ground to a fine paste. That's all that I would want to take now. Add in a little water to it. Water is to be added as per requirement, but the only point to be noted is that water should be minimal. Now let's grind the rice. My first batch of my first portion of batter with the rice is ready, and I'm going to now add it to this udad dal mixture. I think I have ground this for about three and a half minutes, and now let me pick up the second mixture, the second batch, second portion. Please note that in some places where it is cold, fermentation is a difficult process, so you may add a handful of beaten rice, which is also called poha, to it. Or if you have cooked rice, you may add a glass full of cooked rice to it. This aids fermentation, it helps fasten the process of fermentation, and the batter will raise very well. This is my second portion of rice that I'm going to grind, and this too needs to be ground to a fine paste. So I'm going to now grind this for about 3 minutes. Now I've been grinding for the past 3 minutes. So now let me show you the batter. See, the rice is all ground to a fine paste and this consistency. I'm going to add it to the already existing batter that we have removed now. Now this is the amount of water that I have used in grinding this much of batter. This is a 1 liter bottle and I have used this much. So this much could be used for grinding idli. This is the minimal amount of water that I have used for grinding idli. Our batter is now ready. Let's add salt to it. For this amount of batter, I may need 1, 2, and probably another half, 2.5 spoons of salt. Adding in salt always aids the fermentation process. It is also said that beating up the batter or mixing up the batter like this with hands also aids fermentation. It fastens the process of fermentation. Now mix up this batter really well. I have mixed it up nice and well. And let's close this, and this batter should be kept in a warm, dry place and should be fermenting for at least 8 hours. I have kept this on a plate because generally my batter, after fermenting for around 8 hours, actually overflows and oozes out from all sides, and I generally prefer placing it close to my gas stove where there is warmth, sufficient amount of warmth. It is a day's process, friends, but soaking for 6 to 7 hours and then fermenting for 6 to 7 hours will yield very good results and puffy and cloud-like soft idlis. This amount of batter that I have made today will yield anytime more than 30 to 35 idlis. Enjoy making your idlis and do write
to
us.
Hope you like my mom's idli batter recipe. Stay tuned for our aromatic sambar up next. Subscribe our channel and like our video. Happy cooking!